Hey everybody, I got this game today, which some of you might have gotten yesterday as of the 19th, but I got, for the Switch, Yu-Gi-Oh! Legacy of the Duelist Link Evolution. Now, I like Yu-Gi-Oh! But not where it's headed. I'll still buy like the video games and stuff. I used to play it a long time ago, like when it first came out. I kind of stopped playing after the GX series, got back into it late 5Ds, early Zexal, or Zeal, however you want to pronounce it. I know it's probably Zeal from Japan, and America butchers it saying Zexal. I say Zexal anyway, even though I know it butchers it. It just sounds a little better to me for some reason. Anyway, opinions aside, I just wanted to show the unboxing of this game. So here we go. I ended up tearing a little bit of the plastic off to make it a little bit easier. So there you go. Let's see. Also, there's three exclusive cards, which are currently unknown until you open the box, or unless you have done the research where you already know what's in it. Which I have not, so it's going to be complete 100% surprise for me. And let us get on to what I like to call the gamer tradition when opening the box. That new game smell. Okay, so here we go. We have the cards. I'll showcase that in a minute. And no booklet. Yeah, all games are not coming with a booklet anymore. That's kind of a little bit depressing for me. In a lot of the sense, because usually you get, back in the day, you'll get a little booklet, which of course after a while nobody reads, because, well, when you're a kid starting off as a gamer, okay, hang on. Sorry about that. Oop. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and keep that on recording. So what ended up happening is that TV went from DVR to regular TV, and I forgot it does that. So here we go, we have the game, right, here's the camera, right here. It's gonna be blurry, sorry about that, nothing I can do. And then we have the cards. Ooh, that looks, well, it's official, I have my first Link card for Yu-Gi-Oh! Of course, I've never played Duel Links whatsoever. I didn't quite like the idea of it, but I'm going to at least give it a shot, see if I like it or not. And if I don't, hey, at least I tried. And I hear that Konami may be rebooting the series soon, so that way we'll have new cards that, of course, everyone's gonna spend hundreds and hundreds and thousands of dollars making new top tier decks, but hopefully at least the game will be better balanced, you know? So here we go, we have Progleo, a Cybers Link effect monster. Now this is new to me, I don't understand this whatsoever about Cybers, Cybers, but here is the card right here, and I will read the description soon. It's got that cool holographic thing going on. And I'll read the effects. Let's see. Two monsters accept tokens. So I guess there's a specific way to summon it. Requiring two monsters. Not including tokens. I guess you can't use tokens to summon it. Which is basically most monsters nowadays, I think. I'm not sure. Correct me if I'm wrong in the comment section below. During your main phase, if you control this Link summoned card, you can banish this card and one of your monsters this card points to. Okay, so that must be the two orange arrows that are highlighted on the side, the two sides of the card. So on the left side and the right side. It might be backwards for you, but that's how I see it. Anyway, where was I? One of your monsters, wait, You can banish this card and one of your monsters this card points to. Okay, so this could be good for like a banish deck. Points to. Then target one link monster and either GY special summon. Wait, what? Yeah, I'm so out of touch with this current path of Yu-Gi-Oh right now. Please leave a comment in the comment section below to tell me what this means, GY. Okay, so then target one link monster and either GY. Oh wait, I think that's graveyard. Special summon it, but banish it when it leaves the field. You can only use this effect of Proglio once per turn. Okay, so I think I'm starting to actually get it. The only thing I'm not fully grasped yet is how to summon link monsters. So next card is, I have upside down, Cynet Codec. It looks like a infinite, no, sorry. Well, yeah, infinite spell card. I forget what the actual term is. Maybe that is the actual term. But, no, continuous, that's it. So here we go. Looks pretty cool. You know what, looking at it from the phone's camera perspective, it kind of has that elemental look to it. Although, yeah, it does have that elemental look. Oh, there's people on those circles. I don't know if you can see it. Maybe this one right there, my pinky was pointing to. The rest may be hard to see. I kind of see it, but it's blurry. Either way. Continuous spell card. If a Code Talker monster or monsters is special summoned from the extra deck to your field, except during the damage step, you can target one of those monsters. Add one Cybers monster, hence this. Add one Cybers monster with the same attribute from your deck to your hand. Also, you cannot special summon monsters from the extra deck for the rest of this turn. Okay, so it's granting you the ability to special summon from your extra deck, but that's it. It's negating you from doing any more that turn after using this card. Okay, so I wonder if it'll allow you to use the card when you special summon from your extra deck beforehand. Like, if you don't have any way else to summon your extra deck monsters, maybe you can use this, and that'll be the loophole there. I don't know, but let's continue reading. Okay, so deck to your hand. Also, you cannot special summon monsters from your extra deck for the rest of this turn, except Cybers monsters. Okay. So you can only special summon Cybers monsters from your extra deck, but no other kinds when using this card. Okay, so that's its own loophole right there. Even if this card leaves the field. Okay. You cannot add a... Excuse me. You cannot add other Cybers... Come on. You can read. You cannot add other monsters with that same attribute to your hand by the effect of Cynet Codec this turn. But you can do different attributes. So this one right here that I showcased is a light monster. Okay. This turn. And you can only activate the effect of Cynet Codec once per turn. Okay, so doesn't matter if you have three out on the field or two, you can only use one of them once per turn. Okay, so that kind of gives its own hindrance right there. Not that bad, just attempting to make a balance. And then we have here Microcoder, a level 1 Dark Cybers effect monster. I like the fact that it gives... I think this is an ultimate rare card, which I like that a lot. It's kind of hard to get a good reading though from the holographic on the picture of the card though, but I think it is an ultimate rare due to the fact that the attribute and the star is also holographic with the rest of the card being the base picture and the names are out there. So yeah, let's see if I can get, yeah, it looks like it's shiny for you guys, so there you go. Okay, I'm running out of time here. I got 6 minutes left, less than that. So, Cypress Effect Monster, 300 attack point, 0 defense. Oh, also, Prog Leo, he has 1,000 attack and Link 2. I'll have to look that up later. Or you can leave a comment in the comment section below. Let me know what that means. So, effects are, if a Cypress monster you control would be used as link material for a code talker. Code talker. I don't have code talker. I have Micro Coder right here and Prog Leo and then a spell card. I don't know what this means. Oh, code talker monster. This card in your hand can also be used as material. Oh, cool. If this card is sent from your from the hand to the from your hand or field to the graveyard as material for the link summon of a code talker monster, you can either add one Cynet spell trap card from your deck to your hand, or if this card on the field was used as material, you can add one level 4 Cybers monster instead. You can only use each effect of Micro Coder once per turn. Okay, so you can use all of his effects all at once, but just once per turn. So that's pretty cool. Yeah, use all of his effects one turn if you can. And just keep doing it next turn and next turn and next turn. So yeah, there we go. So I'm gonna go ahead and tomorrow I will try out this game and, you know, this is pretty much the make or break for me for when it comes to Yu-Gi-Oh! As playing the games entirely whatsoever. So, a lot of people like it, a lot of people don't. It's a, the way I see it, it's like a 50-50 split. But hey, you know, I guess that's why there's that thing going around. I'm not sure if the rumors are true or what's being talked about is true. If they're going to be rebooting the series and try to make it more balanced, more better. But you know, I'm willing to try the games again to see if it is better if I don't like the current Yu-Gi-Oh! Now. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Again, sooner or later, these unboxing videos will be strictly a Patreon thing eventually. Not sure yet, but they will be eventually. So, if you like this video, click on that like button. If you like me, go ahead and click that subscribe button, and don't forget to ding the bell for more notifications of my next upcoming videos. And don't forget to check my Twitch, Twitter, and Patreon pages, which will be linked in the description box below. And yeah, I'll let you know if I like this in the next video. Love, peace, chicken grease, everybody.